What is up, everyone? My name is Exceptional, and today I'm going to show you guys the best settings you need for Splitgate to make sure you do the best you can. First of all, I am on PC, so this is mostly for PC. I think a lot of these settings are also good for controller. The first thing we need to do is make sure your resolution scale is on 100. That makes sure that you have a very clear image of what you're seeing. Put your FOV at the highest possible. This will give you way more vision so you can see like your peripheral vision very well. If you are on mouse and keyboard, there are some settings you need to do. First of all, maybe it's obvious, maybe it's not, but horizontal and vertical sensitivity should be the same. If you do not have the same vertical and horizontal sensitivity, I do not know what to say to you. Don't turn on mouse smoothing at all. You want no extra input for your mouse. You just want your raw mouse input, so turn that off. Toggle crouch, that you should have toggle crouch off. If you have it on, strafing and crouching will be a little bit more, won't be as smooth. If you have to toggle, you have to press it many more times if you want to strafe crouch. Most of the keybinds are just personal preference, okay? One thing I would definitely change if you're on mouse and keyboard, change your crouch into control and not on the C. If you want to crouch strafe, use AD for left right, but if it's on C, you cannot press C while ADing. Does that make sense? So if you go left right, get left right, and you want to crouch, you have to go with your finger to the C button and you can't go right anymore. So put that on control. It might be a little weird in the beginning, but it will be way better for that purpose. After that, a lot of games normally, when you change weapons, you do not have to press one and two for your second weapon. You can switch weapons by only pressing one. And with Splitgate, you have two weapons. So I would suggest going to inventory and next weapon and put that on one. That means whatever gun you have, switching your weapon is only the one key. You don't need to press one or two or one or two. Sometimes you have situations where you have the AR and the BR. You don't know what one and two is. Just press one with this option and it will automatically switch to the next weapon. After that, you will need to show your damage numbers. It could be very handy. You have a small estimation how many hits you did on your enemy and how low he actually is, so you can do a proper call out to your teammate. Something very important as well is your crosshair color. If you're aimed at the wall or not an enemy, it should be a very bright color, so I do green. And when it's aimed at an enemy, it should be red. The color distinction is very, very clear. After that, go for the smallest dots you can get for your crosshair. That is my preference. I do not want to see anything extra on the screen. I just want to see a little dot so I know where to aim. The rest is just clear vision for me. It only really matters with your battle rifle and your carbine. Those will be your go-to guns mostly. So these are the best settings for Splitgate.